Great. Welcome to the Wednesday, July 12, 2017, City of Salinas Planning Commission. We'll start off with the Pledge of Allegiance. Please join me.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Roll call has been acknowledged.
This time, we'll do welcome and staff introductions.
Jordan Chacon, Administrative Secretary.
Oscar Resendiz, Assistant Planner.
Brady Grossman, Planning Manager.
Megan Hunter, Community Development Director.
Anais Aquino, Senior Deputy City Attorney.
Lisa Brinton, Senior Planner.
Adam Garrett, Assistant Planner.
Thank you. At this time, we'll allow for public comment. Public comment generally are limited to 2 minutes for a speaker. The chairperson may further limit the time for public comments depending on the agenda schedule. This is public comment for anything that's on not on today's agenda. Is there anyone here in the public that would like to speak? Seeing none, we'll close public comment and we'll move to general public comments. Well, I guess that's what we just had. And now we'll move to consent calendar. First item is approval of minutes for the July 19, 2017 mini. Any comments or questions from the commissioners? Is there a motion?
I'll make a motion.
Second. Great. Seeing there's a motion and a second, we have a roll call vote, please.
Commissioner Anzo?
Yes.
Commissioner Giffen?
Yes.
Commissioner Griffin?
Aye.
Commissioner Huerta?
Aye, abstain.
Commissioner Lutz?
Aye.
Commissioner Meeks?
Aye.
And Chairperson Knorr?
Yes. Okay. Public hearing today, we have none scheduled. I think we jump down to other businesses and go to the study session for an overview of the draft economic development element, which will be presented by Senior Planner Lisa Britton.
Good afternoon, Chair, members of the Planning Commission. My name is Lisa Brinton. I'm a senior planner, and it's my pleasure to present to you an overview of the draft economic development element. I'd like to give first a little context of the general plan, because the economic development element will be one of the chapters that we will be considering to become part of our general plan. And by law, a general plan is required to consist of 7 elements, which are listed on the screen. We have chosen to combine 2 of the required elements, conservation and open space, into 1 element in our plan. And we also have an optional element, which is community design. And that is the prerogative of communities. They are, in addition to the 7 required elements, they may adopt other elements focusing on different topic areas. And so the city is going to be considering adding an economic development element to its general plan. So the economic development element, or EDE, would be the 8th element of our plan. And the document as a draft strategy was accepted by the City Council in June 2014 as a comprehensive strategic document that builds on the strategies outlined in the general plan. So in the land use chapter or element, one goal and 8 policies dealing with economic development in the city. And so when, seeing the importance of economic development in creating a prosperous community, the city prepared a more robust strategic plan to complement the strategy already existing in our element and bring it forward as its own chapter. and it provides the vision, context, and focus for the community's efforts, as well as it will provide a framework as we go forward in future plan, general plan updates. The EDE focuses in depth on how the city and community envision an economy that is prosperous, healthy, and environmentally sustainable. And this vision is outlined in and defined in three words: safety, jobs, and health. And those outcomes are achieved through investment in workforce and education, land use, which is private investment and development, as well as quality of life and public safety, which includes investment in services and infrastructure. The document itself, it has eight overriding topic areas that focus on issues and opportunities. Each area identifies goals, policies, and action items. When you look at the EDE as a whole, there are eight topic areas. There are 18 goals, 96 policies, and over 300 action items to address these different topic areas. So it is a very robust and ambitious long-term vision for our community. The EDE also has a chapter regarding monitoring and reporting, because it's important that we collect information to document our progress and set measures of progress and how we are working to achieve the goals outlined in the EDE. And so this reporting is to be an annual process, and it's to be timed with budgeting, so that we can reprioritize and focus the city's resources on economic development priorities in the EDE. And staff developed this matrix, this tool, to assist us with that monitoring and reporting process. And some of the economic indicators that the economic development element identifies as the big needles that we're trying to move through this long-term vision are crime, poverty levels, education levels, unemployment rates, looking at housing, the jobs housing balance, as well as several health and community indicators. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that the implementation of this economic development element is not unilateral. It is a community effort. It was developed through a community engagement process, and it can only be successful if we work with other community partners, such as those on the screen, to implement it. Some of the goals and policies and action items identified are beyond the city's control purview. And so it's important that we work with our education and our business workforce training partners to effectuate the plan. In terms of implementation and the primary areas, land use is one of the primary topic areas. And the element focuses on two different components. It looks at infill development, really strengthening our city center core, and several of the policies and action items call for either implementing existing plans, like the Downtown Vibrancy Plan, or the creation and implementation of new plans for areas in the city center core, such as the Alisal Marketplace, East Salinas, the Alisal Vibrancy Plan, Chinatown Plan, which is underway, and visioning for Carr Lake. The economic development element also looks at opportunities in future growth areas and calls for the preparation and adoption of specific plans for the future development of the West Area, Central Area, and East Area, which are all north of Baranda Road. And currently, the West Area and the Central Area specific plans are moving forward in terms of preparation of environmental review and are anticipated for public review later this year. The EDE identifies several policies and actions regarding circulation and infrastructure to support economic development efforts. And some of the current projects that are underway are the design actually has moved beyond concept of the West Alisal streetscape improvements, which are from Blanco Road to Front Street along East, along West Alisal up to East Alisal. And that would include all the complete streets components of bike lanes, safe pedestrian crossings, and traffic calming measures to improve mobility and circulation. We are also partnering with TAMZ and encouraging their project to push Lincoln Avenue through at Market Street all the way through to the Salinas Intermodal Transit Center to then facilitate the activation of that site for transit-oriented development and prepare it for future rail use. Workforce preparation and diversification is also a big strategy in the element. In focusing on diversification, there's a lot of emphasis on the ag tech ecosystem. Building on the skills and bringing technology into agriculture and how we can build enterprise as well as the skills, higher skills to then be able to have higher paying jobs in the agricultural industry, which is a very big part of our community and economy. So how can we move workers and prepare them to come out of the fields into higher paying jobs as the